Hello princesses! Today I'm going to be doing a little bit of a different video, and this is going to be a planner haul. I feel like a bit of an imposter doing a planner haul because this is my very first planner and I haven't even decorated yet, so I'm totally not part of the community, but I'm going to give it a try because I really like making lists. I like scheduling things and I like to stick to those schedules, so I feel like I used to have diaries when I was in high school. But then I went through a period where I only worked in retail and I didn't have anything to schedule because I just went to work most days. So this is kind of a new thing to me, and the person who actually got me into planning was Saki from X Saki Saki X, I think it's got another one. But I originally started watching Saki because she does Liz Lisa hauls, and oh my god, she is so gorgeous and her fashion sense is so gorgeous. And she did some planning videos and I'd seen this kind of planning before and I didn't really think that I was into it because I see a lot of planners that are just covered in stickers and that's not really my vibe. I don't like that much of it, but watching her plan, I kind of got like to a halfway point of her planning or like three quarters of the way through and I was like, yeah, I like that. But you know, like that's just kind of the way that I got into it, by watching her videos. So she introduced me to this world and I decided to get a planner, and this is pretty much my first planner haul. So I'm just going to talk about what I've got. And I would love some shop suggestions or things that you would recommend for me for now as well. So the planner that I've got here is actually from a brand called Mumsy & Bub. I got it because I liked the colour and I liked the scalloping on the inside, which I'll show you in a second. And it was really cheap because it is not real leather. This is a faux leather. So if you don't want a leather product, this is actually a really beautiful synthetic leather. The only thing I don't like about it is that it has the logo on the back that says Mumsy & Bub. Easy breezy beautiful motherhood, and I am not a mother, so for me it's kind of weird to have something that is pretty much talking about motherhood on the back because I don't have any children, so that's a bit bizarre. But this is the B6 version. I can't remember what color it is. I think it might be called Duchess. No, this one is called Love Note, and it's just like a really pretty like blush kind of color. It's not too pinky pink, so you can see in comparison to like this kind of color. It does work quite well, but if I flip it over with some of the more pinks, it starts to look a little bit more nude. But this is the B6 size, and it has four elastic bands in the center. And if you haven't seen this kind of like traveler's notebook before, I'll show you what the bands mean because I was very confused. This little bow here was actually a freebie from Little Tabby Co, which I got a couple of things from, but it's just basically like a little bow. A rose gold sticker, which I just stuck to the front here, which just gives it like a little bit more interest, which I think is super cute. So with the traveler's notebooks, they do come with the elastic on the outside, and then when you open it up, it kind of pretty much lays flat. But the thing that I liked about the Mumsy & Bub books was that they had this really cute scalloping design on the inside. So it's got one pocket and then like a little secretarial pocket in the front. And then in the back it just has a little scallop pocket as well, which is very, very cute. So in the inside of my planner, I probably should have taken the things out so I could show you what I meant by the bands, but there are these four sets of elastics, so you can see them coming out the back here, and then basically you just thread the paper through there, so the paper itself actually sits flat like that and the band comes through the middle. So this is a B6, which means I need letter sized paper, which actually doesn't exist in New Zealand, so that's a bit of a struggle for me, but yeah. So I've got four sections at the moment. This first section that looks really awful is going to be my monthly, but I need to start the monthly in January because all of the monthly inserts are either half yearly or full yearly. So I didn't want to get an insert for just like the end of November and some of December. It didn't make any sense. So I just used my current monthly planner, which is just a Kiki K, like a rip-off planner. It's so good. It just makes it like they're loose leaflets and you just pull them up when you're done. And then I just kind of like DIY'd it into there. It's just a little bit too big, so you can see that it actually doesn't fit. So I actually can't wait to be done with this. So this is the end of November. So I had a concert and that's pretty much all I needed to write in there because I didn't do anything very much in November. So I will be printing off a monthly insert from Jessenia Printables, which is where I got all of my other inserts from. So these inserts were purchased from Jessenia Printables and then I just printed them at the warehouse stationery because they have nicer paper than I do normally. So this is my weekly view, and I'll show you a page that I haven't written in. But it basically just looks like this, which is the perfect amount of room for me to plan. So there's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then Saturday, Sunday are the small boxes, which for me is great because I do not work on the weekends and I'm pretty relaxed about them. So that is the weekly from Jessenia. Then I have a meal plan section, which I actually find really helpful. So it has a grocery list down the side, some notes, and then it has the meal plan for the week. So what I like to do is plan out what I'm supposed to be eating, and this helps me from like not snacking on things throughout the day. So this is a really cool section as well. And then at the end, I just have a little section for notes. So I have like a little piece of tester vellum in here at the moment because I had no idea if I could print onto vellum, and it's kind of expensive to ship it over because it has to lie flat. So you can see that this one hasn't been cut properly, it's too small, because like I said, we don't have letter size in New Zealand, so everything is A4, and it didn't quite work, but it kind of looks cute in the meantime. And then this is just my notes section. It's just the blank, like a blank sheet of paper basically. So this is what I'm going to be using for teaching. So I just take notes on each student. I have quite a few of them, so I need to make sure that I know what I've been talking to them about so that I can follow it up with them the week after. So that's all I have for inserts for this at the moment. I hate the way that the front looks because at the moment it just looks really like wonky because of the KKK bit, but that's okay. So of course I needed some charms to decorate this with. So I actually got some from Little Tabby Co, which is the people who sent this little bow as a freebie, which is super cute. So the first thing that I got is a little rose gold paper clip. So these are just little glitter paper clips, and they're really handy for actually finding your place. So you can just pop them like in the top like that, and then you'll be able to find where you're supposed to be. Oh my gosh, that's so out of frame. I'm so sorry. And then I got this big blush bow to go on the front. So this has got a little lobster clasp. So that is just what it looks like. It's just got a little lobster clasp and it just hooks on to the front there. And I think that the blush glitter looks so cute with this color. I just didn't know if the rose gold would work that well with it, so that's why I didn't get a rose gold hanging clip. But these are really, really cute and they're such good quality. So these are from Little Tabby Co on Etsy. Pretty much, yeah, literally everything I got was from Etsy, so that's kind of quite cool. They're all like handmade and everything, which is adorable. The next things I got were from the Plan Addict, which put my name on the card, so I can't show you that, but they are super cute. And these came in the cutest packaging of all time. They had all of these little like confetti cutouts, which just went everywhere again. So cute. And like just everything was gorgeous with their packaging. Like it was tied up in the cutest bow. So from them I got a little roll of heart washi. I really want to get some Simply Gilded washi, but like I don't really like the colours at the moment, so I just got some plain white and rose gold heart washi. And they also sent me a little tester sample of some of the other washi that just says hello and has this beautiful floral pattern. I really, really like this one, so if it's still in stock I'll probably get a roll of that, which is really good marketing technique, I gotta say. And I also got this super cute little hanging charm for the outside, like the spine of the book. So it looks like this. It's just got two little pearls down the bottom and it is absolutely adorable and really, really good quality too. These weren't very expensive either, which is fantastic, and they shipped really, really quickly, so these actually got to me so fast. I got a tiny little sheet of these super cute bow checklists, and these are from Sharina Jane on Etsy, and she again sent me a really cute letter, but it has my name on it underneath my thumb, just adorable. So you can see that I've used a couple of these already. They are so gorgeous. So they're basically just a three bow little set of checklists, and the shipping to New Zealand is only $2, which is so good because pretty much anything that I can get from America costs about $20 to ship, even if it's just one little bow, and I'm so sad about that. But she also sent me a little freebie sheet, so it's got some coffee, some butterflies, hearts, payday, and then like a little roll of the, like, I think this is supposed to be like washi strips, I guess. I'm not really sure like of the naming of everything because like I said, I don't really know anything about planning so far, but yeah, that's super cute. I have a couple of random things that I got from other stores. So I have this cute little unicorn pen, which I actually got for teaching because it has like a little horn that I can use to point to things, but it's actually a really great pen. It's like really black and inky, and it was only like $1 from AliExpress, so that is what I'm using at the moment just because I like the quality of the ink. I also had to get a little sharp blade for cutting the washi because, oh my god, you know what annoys me? Not having the washi straight or having the washi that is slightly too long for the boxes. So I had to get like a little, it's like an X-Acto knife, but like nice and hand sized. So this is just from like the warehouse stationery. I don't know what brand it is. And I did originally get some like little clippies to go on the book, but honestly these don't work too well because they're so wide. These are also just from AliExpress. So these are like little heart paper clips, which are really great, but they just, A, don't match the book, and they stick out kind of funnily, so they actually warp the sides of the notebook. And then the same but even worse for these. These are just little heart bulldog clips and they look super, super cute, but some of them are really tough to open. Like I really have to squeeze to get them open. And yeah, because they're so wide, they actually really distort the view of the book. And then last but not least, I got a bunch of stuff from a Merry Merry Belle. I got a bunch of stickers and then I got a Bambi gold foil TN kit, which basically comes with a bunch of paper and vellum and like other little bits and pieces. So I did get pretty much everything from the Bambi range, which, oh my gosh, they are so cute. So there's a bunch of stickers. These are for the Erin Condren Life Planner, I think, but theoretically they are supposed to fit a B6 planner. I haven't tried, so I don't know. So there's just a couple of sheets of these. They are the most gorgeous colors. And I think that they are so cute. These ones I don't think are foiled. Oh, I do like the glitter though. That's so nice. So that is the Bambi kit there. I also got the little Bambi bow header add-ons. I didn't get their other stickers because a lot of them weren't really applicable to me because I had like quite a lot of Bambi things. And then there is a bunch of like die cuts, I think is what they're called, and like little like postcard looking things. Honestly, I don't know the names for everything, so please do forgive me. So there's this one which is gold foil, which is absolutely so beautiful. They have these little square, these like tinier ones, which again, so cute. And then a bunch of these little die cuts. So there's a couple of the baby Bambis, so the baby deers. There's a big deer with a flower crown. Oh, and then there's a bunch of little florals as well. I'm not actually sure what I'm gonna do with these. But yeah, we will see. And then for the other part of their Bambi kit, so this is the gold foil TN kit. There is this piece of acetate, I think it's called, with gold rose printing on it. This is so gorgeous. It's really big though, like this is like an A4 size, so I'm not sure how I'm gonna, like I must have to cut this down myself. Again, we'll see. This is just a piece of like cardstock, I think, that's printed, but the floral and like the watercolors are so pretty. So there's two pages of that, and then there are two pieces of pretty pink rose of vellum, which I think are gorgeous. Sorry for the change of angle and the extra cup of tea. I just had like a flat inspection, so I had to stop mid filming. Oh my gosh. But these are the Jolly 2, which are for the Erin Condren Life Planner 2. I think that these will probably fit the boxes. These are so cute. I ended up going with this one rather than the other one because I think this one had more like, or at least less snow themes, because I'm in New Zealand. We have like summer Christmas, so if I see things that have snow on them, I'm kind of like, can't relate, you know, like I go to the beach instead. But they have a couple of full box stickers and these little quarter boxes. It's kind of like the same format as the Bambi. I think there's more in this one though. These ones, yeah, there's definitely more. I don't know how I'm going to use quite this many stickers up in the month of December, but I'm going to do my best to. These feel so nice, like they just feel like really, really good quality stickers. Obviously, these are the first stickers that I've ever got for planning, so I can't be like, oh my gosh, these are the best quality I've ever tried ever, because, you know, comparing it to itself is not that much, but those are the main stickers. And I did decide to get the extras as well, so this is one of the Jolly Deco add-ons, just because I thought that that tree was gorgeous. And then the bow headers as well. I'm not actually sure if I'm going to be able to use the bow headers that much. Maybe like in the middle of the boxes. I was going to put them like on top underneath the date, but because my one already has bows on it, it's not really going to work. Okay, so I thought I'd just show you everything that's like kind of set up. So you can see the little bow charm on the side as well up here. It does fall over a little bit, but that's fine. And you can see the little bow peeking at the top. The little heart clips actually are not so bad because they're not so chunky at the bottom, so they fit in the top really nicely. So that's kind of what the outside looks like. I don't know how functional this is going to be for me for like taking the band on and off the planner, but it does look really cute when it's just sitting there. I did end up putting some of the die cuts in the front, but I don't know if these are going to stay. Like the pocket's not very tight, so it's already, the like little deer has already fallen out. And this, I wish it was like a bigger size, but I still want to see like the little rose gold foiling, so I don't know if it's going to stay there or not. But I absolutely adore like the little printouts that I got from Merry Me Belle shop. So that one's got like the other side on it, which I think is just so, so pretty. I did have to trim them down because I did read on her website that they are actually A4 sized, which matches up. So I just trimmed them down to the size of my inserts, and I also trimmed this. It looks really dumb, I know, but like it's temporary. I've got the little vellum over the top of my weekly planner, and I put some of the stickers in, so I'll show you a week that I haven't filled out. So that's just what one of the bland weeks looks like. So obviously this is opening for the week that's coming up. These weekend ones, because it's not an Erin Condren planner, it's too wide for my actual weekend because my weekend's on two little boxes there. But yeah, that's kind of messy. I don't like it, but whatever. It's stuck down now and I can't pull it off. So that's kind of what this looks like. And then I actually did stick some of my holiday stickers in as well because I needed to schedule and plan for the dates that I'm stopping at some of my schools. So after the weekly, I have my meal, and I kind of just doubled up with the acetate and the white side of the paper because the meal plan, the header isn't that really, not really that pretty. And the heart clip is marking where I am for the week. So that's the empty version there. And then at the very end, I've just got the vellum over the notes, which I think is really cute. And I don't have anything in the back at the moment, so yeah. That's pretty much my brand new planner, and it is so cute. I'm dying. It annoys me that like the pinks don't really match up, but at least this pink matches this one. It doesn't look quite as mismatched as the front does look a little bit funny having such a purpley pink here. It really looks purple, but in reality it's just that this pink is kind of like a brown pink. So that is it for this planner haul. I'm sorry about the like mess on that side. It's so messy. I'm gonna clean it up now. If you guys are interested in seeing more planner hauls or like little plan with me videos, just let me know. I haven't done any planner stuff on this channel yet, obviously. But if you guys are not interested, then I just won't do any more and I'll just do this at home by myself, and that's totally cool too. So just let me know what you guys thought of this video. If you have any recommendations for me, I would love to hear them because, like I said, I am 100% new to this world, but I am so excited about it, so I can't wait to start using some stickers. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time. Bye!